Cook, 60, has become a billionaire thanks to Apple's skyrocketing stock price, which has allowed him to reap top bonuses year after year. According to Bloomberg Billionaires Index, he has a net worth of around $1.5 billion. Tim Cook, on the other hand, has no intention of sitting on the wealth he's gotten from Apple. Cook chose to give away all of his riches, according to Fortune, with exception of a little piece that will probably be used to put his nephew through college. He intends to donate the money to charity. Cook has spoken out on a number of issues, including human rights, immigration reform, and the prevention of HIV transmission, according to Fortune. He's increasingly used his position at Apple as a platform to speak out about topics that matter to him. He tells Fortune, "You want to be the pebble in the pond that creates the ripple for change." At Apple's current closing price of $503.43, Cook contributed a total of 10,715 shares, worth $5.4 million. The SEC filing does not specify where Cook's money was donated. Cook contributes roughly $5 million worth of stock to charity every year in August. Cook still owns 837,374 shares of Apple stock, worth $422 million after the contribution. Keep in mind that despite Apple's great stock performance, every individual stock can outperform or underperform, and previous performance does not guarantee future outcomes. Before you invest in the stock market, make sure you thoroughly investigate your options. Timothy Donald Cook is an American business executive who has served as Apple Inc.'s chief executive officer since 2011. Cook previously worked as the company's chief operations officer under Steve Jobs, the company's co-founder. Cook joined Apple as a senior vice president of global operations in March 1998 and later became the executive vice president of global sales and operations. Prior to Jobs' death in October of that year, he was appointed CEO on August 24, 2011. He has campaigned for the legislative reform of domestic and global monitoring, cybersecurity, American economy, and preservation of natural resources during his time as president. Cook doubled Apple's sales and profit from 2011 to 2020, and the company's market value climbed from $348 billion to $1.9 trillion during that time. Cook made history when he became the first CEO of a Fortune 500 business to publicly come out as gay in 2014. Cook is also a regent of Duke University and participates on the directors of Nike Inc. and the National Football Foundation. Tim Cook has been Apple's CEO for 10 years, succeeding co-founder Steve Jobs. In the subsequent decade, Cook transformed the Cupertino, California-based computer company from a Silicon Valley behemoth to the world's largest publicly traded corporation. According to CNBC calculations, if you invested $1,000 in Apple on the day Cook became CEO in 2011, your shares would be worth $12,970.28 now. A $1,000 investment in the S&P 500 index, on the other hand, would have returned 365.9% during the same time frame and would have been worth around $4,659. Though Cook hasn't initiated many new tech products, the Apple Watch and AirPods released in 2015 and 2016 respectively are the two most prominent new devices introduced under his watch, with the remainder coming in the form of regular advancements to iPhones, iPads, and Macs. Cook has strengthened Apple's earnings by utilizing its massive loyal customer base into a repeated source of subscription revenue. In fiscal year 2011, Apple's services division, which includes the Apple News Plus magazine subscription service and the streaming platform Apple TV Plus, brought in $2.95 million, a figure that is expected to rise to $53.77 billion by fiscal year 2020. Apple has expanded from a market cap of $364.4 billion to $2.45 trillion during Cook's leadership, becoming the first publicly traded US firm to surpass a $1 trillion market cap in 2018 and $2 trillion just over 2 years later. Apple's journey hasn't been without bumps. Users, competitors, and Washington have all criticized the firm in recent years for a variety of practices, including the 30% fee it imposes on most App Store operations. In August 2021, Apple Inc. CEO Tim Cook received the 10th and last installment of his 10-year salary package, which began when he took over the top job from co-founder Steve Jobs a decade ago. According to Bloomberg News calculations, the haul consists of nearly 5 million shares worth $750 million. Part of the dividend is conditional on Apple's stock outperforming at least two-thirds of firms in the S&P 500 during the past 3 years, a mark that the iPhone manufacturer easily surpassed. Becoming the CEO from one of the world's richest firms has many advantages. This includes providing you with a substantial amount of your personal wealth,